गुड मॉर्निंग गाइस एंड लाइक द डिस्क्रिप्शन सेज हाउ टू मेक मनी आउट ऑफ बैंक निफ्टी कॉल्स और हाउ टू प्रिडिक्ट बैंक निफ्टी ऑन अ डेली बेसिस इज व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस. लाइक यू कैन सी आई हैव द थर्ड ट्रेड गोइंग फॉर टुडे एंड द थर्ड ट्रेड इज़ फॉर बैंक निफ्टी में 17,500 PE विच इज़ इन पॉजिटिव नोट राइट नाउ. आई हैव जस्ट स्टार्टेड दिस ट्रेड. बिफोर दिस ट्रेड आई हैड made money using bank nifty 17,800 CE. I closed the trade for 50% profit. I invested 2000 rupees on that and bank nifty May 18,000 CE 494 rupees again 2000 rupees investment and gained back almost 25% of it. So the first trade gave me 50% returns, second trade gave me 25% returns, and I have put another trade bank nifty May 17,500 PE 5561 rupees right now. Let's see how this trade will close. So if you are interested to know this strategy, if you want to learn this strategy and start making money by yourself, you can contact me on 9113211787. I will schedule a 1 hour or half an hour discussion with you separately so that I can clearly explain using the strategy. I will clearly explain what has to be done. Capital will remain very minimal for all the trades that we are doing, especially bank nifty. It is a hero or a zero call that we look at. So if you are interested, do let me know. We can schedule a one-on-one session for this trading strategy. Thank you very much, guys. If you are a first time viewer of this channel, I recommend you to subscribe to the channel, click the bell icon for notifications. We upload videos every day and you will be notified first when the video is uploaded. You can reach out to us on 9113211787 for any queries you have. We are registered on WhatsApp with the same number. You can join the secret Telegram channel using the same number, using the link in the description box below, where we post videos and we discuss strategies. If you don't have a trading account, I recommend you to open a trading account with Zerodha, which will not take more than 5 to 10 minutes. If you have all the KYC documents ready, the link is in the description box below. Go open an account right now. And please do not forget to like, share and comment on the video. If you have already subscribed, please stay updated with us. Share the videos with your friends and thank you very much for your support. Guys, moving on to the next chapter, which is the trading terminal. We are going to talk about Zerodha's trading terminal or how to use Zerodha application. When a market participant wants to transact in the market, he can do so by opting one of the options called the stock broker and trade, usually called as call and trade. Use a web browser to access the markets, second one. The third one is use the trading software called the trading terminal. We are going to talk about the trading terminal Zerodha today. So each one of the above method is a gateway to the exchanges. The gateway allows you to do multiple things such as transacting in shares, tracking your profit and loss, tracking market movements, following news, managing your funds, viewing your charts, accessing trading tools, etc. The purpose of this chapter is to familiarize you with the trading terminal and its interface. A trading terminal is a software which can be downloaded from your broker's website and is installed on your computer. And the trading terminal is quite a user-friendly interface, as most of its functionalities are menu-driven. To access the terminal, you need to have a trading account with a broker. A good trading terminal offers you numerous useful features. We will start by understanding a few basic features. To keep this chapter as practical as possible, let us set two basic tasks using the trading terminal. Buy one share of ITC and second one is track the price of Infosys. While we achieve the above two tasks, we will also learn about the relevant concepts. For the purpose of this chapter, we are going to use Zerodha's web platform, which is Kite. So how do you log into Kite? If you don't have an account with Zerodha, guys, please go and check the link in the description box below. You will find a link through which you can open an account with Zerodha. They will charge you 300 to 500 rupees depending on the kind of account that you want to open. If you want only equity, they will charge you 300 rupees. If you want commodities and futures currencies option enabled on your account, they will charge you 500 rupees. If you have all the KYC documents ready with you, it will not take more than 5 minutes to open an account. So once you open an account, you will be receiving an email with your credentials. You can use the Kite web platform to log in, or you can also use Zerodha's Kite application on your Android and Apple phones. So it is also available in other platforms. You can use it on your iPad, you can use it on your tablets if you have. So Kite application is widely used by traders, and it is a very simple platform and very sleek and simple platform where you can see the numbers that you only want to see. That is something I always say when I'm making videos, when I'm telling people to open Zerodha account. So the trading terminal is quite sensitive as it contains all your trading account information. In order to ensure adequate security, brokers usually follow a stringent login process. The process involves entering your password and answering two secret questions. The answers to which you know the snapshot is below as the process. So basically, this was one old procedure that Zerodha used to follow. Now they have shifted from just entering one password and the pin, secret pin, 6-digit secret pin that you have to set. And if you have fingerprint allowed on your mobile phone, you can also log in using the fingerprint, which is one touch on your phone these days, which is very easy. The document is fairly old one. I'm using this document because Zerodha has openly given this document to download, and it is free to use. So when the document was made, that particular feature was not there, and now they have enabled the option to log in using fingerprint. So guys, the concept that we are explaining in the video, the document that we are using, the concepts of the stock markets remains the same, but the platform evolves over a period of time as and when technology improves. So let's move on to the market watch. So what happens now is once you log into the platform, you will have to populate the market watch, which is on the left hand side. So when you open the market watch, your watch list, or you can see all the stocks that you are interested in. Think about the market watch as a blank slate. Once the stock is loaded onto the market watch, can be easily added. Transact and query information can also be looked at. Stock is loaded onto your market watch and you can easily transact or query information about it. A blank market which looks like this. This is also a screen where you see your login, and you can also see a dashboard, orders, holdings, positions, funds and applications. We'll get to that explaining later. So keeping the first task in mind, we will load ITC onto our market watch list. To do this, we have to simply have to type the stock symbol or ITC in the search bar, and the drop down will show the stock in different exchanges, NSE or BSE. So click on the add symbol to add the stock into market watch. So now the market watch is added. The market watch will display the last traded price of the particular stock, percentage of stock, and the last traded price of the stock, which is last LTP, which is known as a jargon, and this gives us a sense of how much stock is trending at that particular moment. Percentage change, this indicates the percentage change points the live trading price is varying with respect to the previous day's close. So some of the basic information that will be needed at this point would be previous day's close, at what price did the stock close, at what price did the stock open. Like we have OHLC, which is open, high and low. So This gives us a sense of range with the stock is trading during the day, and the volumes gives us a sense of how many shares are being traded at a particular point of time. You can sell this in, you can find this information under the market depth. If you have however the stock name, you will find it by sell, market depth and stock information. If you click on market depth, you will find information along with the best bid and ask price ladder. We will be covering bid and price, bid and ask price in the later part of the chapter. So guys, take a second and just look at the screen. So we have the number of bids, we have offers, we have open low volume and LTQ. So high and close average prices are also given for your understanding. So let's look at other options which are given in the Zerodha platform. As you can see, the last traded price of ITC is 262 rupees, and it is trading at low of 0.04%, so which was the previous day's close. Rupees 263.30 was the previous day's close. The open of the day was 265.90, the highest price and the lowest price at which this stock was traded for that particular day was rupees 265.90 and 262.15 respectively. The volume for the day is close to 27 lakh shares. Buying a stock through the trading terminal, our goal is to buy one share of ITC. Now we have ITC our trading terminal, and we are convinced that buying ITC at rupees 261, which is roughly 1.25 lesser than the last traded price, is a great idea. The first step for this process would be to invoke what is called as the order form. Guys, take a second and look at the order form. Okay, so the first step that you see is called the order form. However, the stock you want to buy, and click on the buy icon. This will invoke the buy, and the buy from the button that you press will appear on the screen. You see, basically you have buy and sell button. You can click on buy so that you can buy the particular share. You can click on sell. You can see a right hand top corner toggle. If you click on that, it will go to sell option. So that particularly said, Zerodha gives you Zerodha also gives you an option to put stop loss. Zerodha also gives you an option to set the trigger price at which that you want to sell that particular trade, buy that particular trade. So all these options are provided. The order form is pre-populated. One second. The order form is pre-populated with some information like the price and quantity we need to modify. This is as per our requirement. Let us begin by the first drop-down option on the top. By default, the exchanges specified would be NSE. The next entry type is order type. By clicking on the drop down, you will see the following options: limit, market, stop loss, market. So let us understand what actually limit means. You can opt for a limit order when you are very particular about the price that you want to pay for a stock. In case the last traded price of the ITC was 262.25 rupees, but we want to limit our buy price to 261. In such a situation, we are particular about the price we want to transact in. We can opt for a limit order price. If the price does not fall 261, you will not get these shares. So this is one of the drawbacks of a limit order. You can also opt for a market order when you intend to buy at the market available prices instead of a very specific price that you have in your mind. So if you were to place a trade, or if you were to place a market order, As long as there are sellers available, you will order go through the ITC stock, which will be bought at the in the vicinity of rupees 262.25, which means if you have placed an order at 260, the stock will be bought around 260 rupees. The same thing is explained here. Suppose the price goes up to 265 coinciding with the market order placement, then you will get rupees ITC at rupees 265. This means you place a market order, you will never be sure of the price at which you would transact, and this would be quite dangerous situation if you are an active trader. The next one is a stop loss order. This protects you from adverse movements in the market after initiating a position. Suppose you buy ITC at 262 rupees with an exception that ITC will hit 275 in the future, but instead what if the price of the ITC starts going down? That is, we can protect ourselves firstly by defining what would be the worst possible loss you are willing to take. For instance, in the example, let us assume you don't want to take a loss beyond 255 rupees. This means you have gone long on ITC rupees 262, and the maximum loss that you are willing to take on this particular trade is 6 rupees, which is 255. If the stock price drops down to 255, the stop loss order or the order gets active and hits the exchange, you will be out of the loss making position. As long as the price is above 255, the stop loss order will be dormant. A stop loss order is a passive order. In order to activate it, we need to enter a trigger price. A trigger price usually above the stop loss sets or acts as the price threshold. Only after crossing the price, stop loss and transitions from a passive order to an active order. So let us understand this example, guys. Take a second and look at the example. We are going long at rupees 261. In this case, trade goes bad. We would want to get rid of the position 255. Therefore, 255 is the stop loss. The trigger price is specified that the stop loss order would transition from passive to active order. The trigger price has to be higher than the stop loss price. We can set this at 256 rupees. If the price drops to 256 from 255, the stop loss gets active. Going back to the main buy order form, once the order type is selected, we now move directly to the quantity. Remember, the task is to buy one share of ITC, hence we enter only one in the quantity box. We ignore the trigger price and the disclosed quantity for now. The next thing to do is we need to select the product type. How do we select the product type? That is one important thing we have to pay attention to. So if you are selecting CNC for delivery trades, meaning if you have intention to buy and hold the shares for multiple days, months, years, or you need to ensure the shares reside in your DMAT account, selecting cash and carry in your own way of communication, or it is the way that you communicate with your broker. So when you select one of these orders are filled in your form and the order is good to hit the market, the order gets transmitted to the exchange. As soon as you press the button, submit button on the order form, a unique ticket number is generated against your order and it is sent to stock exchange. So before that, you also need to check if you are selecting a normal or NRML or MIS, which is MIS is a margin product. We will understand this in the future videos that we are going to make. So now what is going to happen is we have already known how to place an order, what script to select, what instrument to select, which company to select, and how to add the particular trade, how to buy, how to toggle between sell. And we have also understood what is MIS and what is normal. Normal is you have money for the share that you want to buy, adequate amount of money that you want to buy a share and hold it. Or if you are an intraday trader, you have the 100 rupees, for example, Zerodha gives you 7 to 14% leverage on a particular stock, depending on the volatility, depending on the particular stock. So you can take leverage and you can start trading using the Zerodha's leverage platform. So let's move on to the order book or the trade book. Just in case if you have missed out on the document, understanding the document that we are explaining, you can download it using the link in the description box below. You can always rewind this video to understand the concepts better. You can take a pause, you can stop this video, because these videos are going to be lengthy. You can pause this video, you can come back and resume the video to understand. And no, I would definitely suggest you guys to note down or to highlight all the key points that we are discussing. Make a note of it so that you go and refer back those points as and when there is confusion, as and when there is clarification required, you can go back and check those points. So next point is the order book and the trade book. So the order book and the trade book are two online registries within the trading terminal. The order book keeps track of all the orders that you have set sent to the exchange, and the trade book tracks all the trades that you have transacted during the day. The order book has all the details ordering regarding your order. You can navigate to the order book by clicking the others tab. Guys, take a second, take a minute and look at this particular platform which is there. This is your order book. There are open orders, ITC, you want to buy one quantity, cash and carry, live trading price is 262, price that you want to buy is 261.00. The order book provides the details of the orders that you have placed. You should access the order book to double check if the order details, quantity, price, order price, or the product type. Modify the orders. For example, if you want to modify the order from 332 to 333, you can do this from the order book. So next one is check status. After you have placed the order, you can check the status of the same. The status would state open if the order is completely or partially open. It would state completed if the order has been completed. It would state rejected if your order book has been rejected. You can also see the details of rejection in the order book. Now if you notice, there is one order which is open for ITC at 261 rupees. If you however have any pending orders, you can find it in the option to modify or cancel the order. So guys, by clicking modify, and the order form will invoke, and you can make desired changes to the order. Once the order has been processed and the trade has been executed, the trade details will be available in the trade book. You can find the trade book just below the order book. Here is a snapshot of the trade book. By clicking on modify, the order form will be invoked and you can make the desired changes to the order. Once the order has been processed and the trade has been executed, the trade details will be available in the trade book. You can find the trade book just below the order book. Here is a snapshot of your trade book. The trade book confirms that the user executed an order by one share ITC at rupees 262.2. Also notice a unique exchange order number is generated for the trade. So with this cover, the first task is completed. Now we can officially own, or now you officially own one share of ITC. This share will reside in your DMAT account till you decide to square it off. So the next task is to track the price of Infosys. The step would be to add Infosys to the market watch. We can do this by searching the Infosys's share in the search box. So when you search for INFI, that is INFI, the stock code of the particular stock that we are searching, which is Infosys, you can add by clicking on the green arrow button. The trading symbol of the Infosys is INFI. Once we select INFI, we press and add it to the market watch. So guys, this is how the terminal looks like. This is how you add a stock. We can now track some live information about Infosys. The last traded price is 1014.75 rupees. The stock is minus 0.11% from the previous day's close of 1015.85 rupees. Infosys opened up today, I mean the day when this document was made, at rupees 1014 plus 80 paisa, which is 1014 rupees 80 paisa, made low of 998 rupees and 40 paisa and a higher of 1028 rupees and 95 paisa. The volumes were 3.6 million shares. Please note, while opening while the open price will be at 1014 rupees and 80 paisa, the high and the low prices will change when the price of Infosys changes. For example, if Infosys moves to rupees 1014.2 to 1050, then the prices will reflect as 1050 as a new high. Notice the live trading price of Infosys, which is highlighted in green, and ITC is in red. If the current live trading price is more than the previous live trading price, the sell is highlighted in green, else it is in red. So let's look at the snapshot below to understand. ITC is in red, which means it is going down, and INFI is going up, which is in green. So the price of Infosys dropped from 1014 rupees 20 paisa to 1020 rupees 80 paisa, hence the color changed to red from blue. So besides the basic information about live trading price, open, high, low and close, and volume, we can also dig a bit deeper about understanding the real time market participation. To see this, we need to invoke what is called as market depth window, also referred to as snapcode window. You can also see there is a lot of information in the snap window. I specifically want to draw attention to the numbers in blue and red called bid and ask prices. You can use Kite by Zerodha more effectively by going through the user manual. The first one is the bid and ask price. If you want to buy a share, you obviously need to buy it from a seller. The seller will sell the share at the price that he thinks it is fair. The price that the seller asks you is called the ask price. The ask price is highlighted in red. Let us analyze this in a bit more detail. So by default, the snap quote window displays the top five bid ask prices, and in the table above we have the top five ask prices. The first ask price is ₹3,294.80. At this particular moment, this is the best time to buy. This is the best price to buy Infosys, and there are only two shares available at this price being offered by two different sellers. Both of them are selling ₹1 each. The next best price is ₹3,294.85. At this price, there are four shares available offered at two different sellers. The third best price is 3295, at which 8 shares are available, and this price is offered by two sellers, so on and so forth. As you notice, the higher the risk, higher the ask price, the lower the priority is. For example, at the fifth position, there is an ask price of 3296.25 for 5 shares. This is because the stock exchange gives priority to sellers willing to sell their shares at the least possible price. Notice, if you want to buy 10 shares at 3294.8, and you can only buy two shares because there are only two sellers at 3294. However, if you want to, or if you are not particular about the price, ask a limit, also known as the limit price. You can place an order when you place an order in the market at this stage, this is what happens. Two shares are bought at 3294.8, four shares are bought at 3294.85, four shares are bought at 3294.00. The shares, 10 shares will be bought at three different prices. Also in the process, the live trading price of the Infosys will jump from 3295 to 3294.8. So if you want to sell a share, you obviously need to sell it to a buyer willing to buy it from you. The buyer will be able to buy the share at the price that he thinks it is fair. The price that the buyer demands is called the bid price. The bid price highlighted in blue, let us analyze this part in bold, this part in detail, bit more detail. Again, by the default, the snap quote window displays the top 5 bid prices. Notice the best price at which you can sell the share is ₹3294.75, and at this price you can actually sell 10 shares, as there are only 5 buyers willing to buy from you. So if you were to sell 20 shares of Infosys, market price, the following would be the execution pattern. 10 shares are sold at 3294, 6 shares are sold at 3294.20, 1 share is sold at 3294.15, 3 shares are sold at 3293.85. So in this essence, the bid and ask price gives you the information about the top 5 prices which the buyer and seller are stacked up. It is extremely important for you to understand how the buyer and sellers are placing their trade, especially if you are an intraday trader. So conclusion is, the trading terminal is your gateway to the market. Trading terminal has many features that are useful to traders. We will explore these features as we progress through the various learning modules. For now, we should be in a position to understand how the market is set up and the market watch is set up. Transaction of both buy and sell in stocks are also understood. The view of the order book, the trade of the trade that you are doing, the trade book, very essential to know and understand the market depth window. So guys, key takeaway from this chapter: a trading terminal is your gateway to markets. You must know the operations of a trading terminal if you aspire to become an active trader. Second point is, you can load the stock that you are interested onto market watch to track all the relevant information. Third one is, some of the basic information on the market watch is live trading price, percentage change, OHLC and volumes. To buy a stock, you need to invoke a buy order from by pressing the B key. Likewise, to sell a stock, you need to invoke a sell order by pressing the S key. So it is basically, buying is B button, yes, sell is yes button, simple as that. So you choose to limit order type when you are keen on transacting at a particular price, else you can opt for a market order. You can choose cash and carry as a product type if you want to buy and hold the stock across multiple days if you want to trade. Guys, moving on to the next chapter, which is the trading terminal, we are going to talk about Zerodha's trading terminal, or how to use Zerodha application. When a market participant wants to transact in the market, he can do so by opting one of the options called the stock broker and trade, usually called as call and trade. Use a web browser to access the markets, second one. The third one is use the trading software called the trading terminal. We are going to talk about the trading terminal Zerodha today. So each one of the above method is a gateway to the exchanges. The gateway allows you to do multiple things, such as transacting in shares, tracking your profit and loss, tracking market movements, following news, managing your funds, viewing your charts, accessing trading tools, etc. The purpose of this chapter is to familiarize you with the trading terminal and its interface. A trading terminal is a software which can be downloaded from your broker's website and is installed on your computer. at the trading terminal is quite a user-friendly interface, as most of its functionalities are menu driven. To access the terminal, you need to have a trading account with a broker. A good trading terminal offers you numerous useful features. We will start by understanding a few basic features. To keep this chapter as practical as possible, let us set two basic tasks using the trading terminal. Buy one share of ITC, and second one is track the price of Infosys. While we achieve the above two tasks, we will also learn about the relevant concepts. For the purpose of this chapter, we are going to use Zerodha's web platform, which is Kite. So how do you log into Kite? If you don't have an account with Zerodha, guys, please go and check the link in the description box below. You will find the link through which you can open an account with Zerodha. They will charge you 300 to 500 rupees depending on the kind of account that you want to open. If you want only equity, they will charge you 300 rupees. If you want commodities and futures currencies option enabled on your account, they will charge you 500 rupees. If you have all the KYC documents ready with you, it will not take more than 5 minutes to open an account. So once you open an account, you will be receiving an email with your credentials. You can use the Kite web platform to log in, or you can also use Zerodha's Kite application on your Android and Apple phones. So it is also available in other platforms. You can use it on your iPad, you can use it on your tablets if you have. So Kite application is widely used by traders, and it is a very simple platform and very sleek and simple platform where you can see the numbers that you only want to see. That is something I always say when I'm making videos, when I'm telling people to open Zerodha account. So the trading terminal is quite sensitive, as it contains all your trading account information. In order to ensure adequate security, brokers usually follow a stringent login process. The process involves entering your password and answering two secret questions. The answers to which, you know, the snapshot is below as the process. So basically, this was one old procedure that Zerodha used to follow. Now they have shifted from just entering one password and the PIN, secret PIN, 6-digit secret PIN that you have to set. And if you have fingerprint allowed on your mobile phone, you can also log in using the fingerprint, which is one touch on your phone these days, which is very easy. The document is fairly old one. I'm using this document because Zerodha has openly given this document to download, and it is free to use. So when the document was made, that particular feature was not there, and now they have enabled the option to log in using fingerprint. So guys, the concepts that we are explaining in the video, the document that we are using, the concepts of the stock markets remains the same, but the platform evolves over a period of time as and when technology improves. So let's move on to the market watch. So what happens now is, once you log in to the platform, you will have to populate the market watch, which is on the left hand side. So when you open the market watch, your watch list, or you can see all the stocks that you are interested in. Think about the market watch as a blank slate. Once the stock is loaded onto the market watch, can be easily added. Transact and query information can also be looked at. Stock is loaded onto your market watch and you can easily transact or query information about it. A blank market which looks like this. This is also a screen where you see your login, and you can also see a dashboard, orders, holdings, positions, funds and applications. We'll get to that explaining later. So keeping the first task in mind, we will load ITC onto our market watch list. To do this, we have to simply have to type the stock symbol or ITC in the search bar, and the drop down will show the stock in different exchanges, NSE or BSE. So click on the add symbol to add the stock into market watch. So now the market watch is added. The market watch will display the last traded price of the particular stock, percentage of stock, and the last traded price of the stock, which is last LTP, which is known as a jargon. And this gives us a sense of how much stock is trending at that particular moment. Percentage change, this indicates the percentage change points the live trading price is varying with respect to the previous day's close. So some of the basic information that will be needed at this point would be previous day's close, at what price did the stock close, at what price did the stock open, like we have OHLC, which is open high and low. So this gives us a sense of range with the stock is trading during the day, and the volumes gives us a sense of how many shares are being traded at a particular point of time. You can sell this in, you can find this information under the market depth. If you have however the stock name, you will find it buy, sell, market depth and stock information. If you click on market depth, you will find information along with the best bid and ask price ladder. We will be covering bid and price, bid and ask price in the later part of the chapter. So guys, take a second and just look at the screen. So we have the number of bids, we have offers, we have open low, volume and LPQ. So high and close average prices are also given for your understanding. So let's look at other options which are given in the Zerodha platform. As you can see, the last traded price of ITC is 262 rupees, and it is trading at low of 0.04%, so which was the previous day's close. Rupees 263.30 was the previous day's close. The open of the day was 265.90, the highest price and the lowest price at which this stock was traded for that particular day was rupees 265.90 and 262.15 respectively. The volume for the day is close to 27 lakh shares. Buying a stock through the trading terminal, our goal is to buy one share of ITC. Now we have ITC, our trading terminal, and we are convinced that buying ITC at rupees 261, which is roughly 1.25 lesser than the last traded price, is a great idea. The first step of for this process would be to invoke what is called as the order form. Guys, take a second and look at the order form. Okay, so the first step that you see is called the order form. However, the stock you want to buy, and click on the buy icon. This will invoke the buy, and the buy from the button that you press will appear on the screen. You see, basically you have buy and sell button. You can click on buy so that you can buy the particular share. You can click on sell. You can see a right hand top corner toggle. If you click on that, it will go to sell option. So that particularly said, Zerodha gives you all, Zerodha also gives you an option to put stop loss. Zerodha also gives you an option to set the trigger price at which that you want to sell that particular trade, buy that particular trade. So all these options are provided. The order form is pre-populated. One second. Order form is pre-populated with some information like the price and quantity we need to modify. This is as per our requirement. Let us begin by the first drop-down option on the top. By default, the exchanges specified would be NSE. The next entry type is order type. By clicking on the drop down, you will see the following options: limit, market, stop loss, market. So let us understand what actually limit means. You can opt for a limit order when you are very particular about the price that you want to pay for a stock. In case the last traded price of the ITC was 262.25 rupees, but we want to limit our buy price to 261. In such a situation, we are particular about the price we want to transact in. We can opt for a limit order price. If the price does not fall 261, you will not get these shares. So this is one of the drawbacks of a limit order. You can also opt for a market order when you intend to buy at the market available prices instead of a very specific price that you have in your mind. So if you were to place a trade, or if you were to place a market order, as long as there are sellers available, you will order go through the ITC stock, which will be bought at the in the vicinity of rupees 262.25, which means if you have placed an order at 260, the stock will be bought around 260 rupees. The same thing is explained here. Suppose the price goes up to 265 coinciding with the market order placement, then you will get rupees ITC at rupees 265. This means you place a market order, you will never be sure of the price at which you would transact, and this would be quite dangerous situation if you are an active trader. The next one is a stop loss order. This protects you from adverse moments in the market after initiating a position. Suppose you buy ITC at 262 rupees with an exception that ITC will hit 275 in the future, but instead, what if the price of the ITC starts going down? That is, we can protect ourselves firstly by defining what would be the worst possible loss you are willing to take. For instance, in the example, let us assume you don't want to take a loss beyond 255 rupees. This means you have gone long on ITC rupees 262, and the maximum loss that you are willing to take on this particular trade is 6 rupees, which is 255. If the stock price drops down to 255, the stop loss order or the order gets active and hits the exchange, you will be out of the loss making position. As long as the price is above 255, the stop loss order will be dormant. A stop loss order is a passive order. In order to activate it, we need to enter a trigger price. A trigger price usually above the stop loss sets or acts as the price threshold. Only after crossing the price, stop loss and transitions from a passive order to an active order. So let us understand this example, guys. Take a second and look at the example. We are going long at rupees 261. In this case, trade goes bad. We would want to get rid of the position 255. Therefore, 255 is the stop loss. The trigger price is specified that the stop loss order would transition from passive to active order. The trigger price has to be higher than the stop loss price. We can set this at 256 rupees. If the price drops to 256 from 255, the stop loss gets active. Going back to the main buy order form, once the order type is selected, we now move directly to the quantity. Remember, the task is to buy one share of ITC, hence we enter only one in the quantity box. We ignore the trigger price and the disclosed quantity for now. The next thing to do is we need to select the product type. How do we select the product type? That is one important thing we have to pay attention to. So if you are selecting CNC for delivery trades, meaning if you have intention to buy and hold the shares for multiple days, months, years, or you need to ensure the shares reside in your DMAT account, selecting cash and carry in your own way of communication, or it is the way that you communicate with your broker. So when you select one of these orders are filled in your form and the order is good to hit the market, the order gets transmitted to the exchange as soon as you press the button, submit button on the order form. A unique ticket number is generated against your order and it is sent to stock exchange. So before that, you also need to check if you are selecting a normal or NRML or MIS, which is MIS is a margin product. We will understand this in the future videos that we are going to make. So now what is going to happen is we have already known how to place an order, what script to select, what instrument to select, which company to select, and how to add the particular trade, how to buy, how to toggle between sell, and we have also understood what is MIS and what is normal. Normal is you have money for the share that you want to buy, adequate amount of money that you want to buy a share and hold it, or if you are an intraday trader, you have the 100 rupees, for example, Zerodha gives you 7 to 14% leverage on a particular stock, depending on the volatility, depending on the particular stock. So you can take leverage and you can start trading using the Zerodha's leverage platform. So let's move on to the order book or the trade book. Just in case if you have missed out on the document, understanding the document that we are explaining, you can download it using the link in the description box below. You can always rewind this video to understand the concepts better. You can take a pause, you can stop this video, because these videos are going to be lengthy. You can pause this video, you can come back and resume the video to understand. And no, I would definitely suggest you guys to note down or to highlight all the key points that we are discussing. Make a note of it so that you go and refer back those points as and when there is confusion, as and when there is clarification required, you can go back and check those points. So next point is the order book and the trade book. So the order book and the trade book are two online registries within the trading terminal. The order book keeps track of all the orders that you have set sent to the exchange, and the trade book tracks all the trades that you have transacted during the day. The order book has all the details ordering regarding your order. You can navigate to the order book by clicking the other tab. Guys, take a minute and look at this particular platform which is there. This is your order book. There are open orders, ITC, you want to buy one quantity, cash and carry, live trading price is 262, price that you want to buy is 261.00. The order book provides the details of the orders that you have placed. You should access the order book to double check if the order details, quantity, price, order price, or the product type. Modify the orders. For example, if you want to modify the order from 332 to 333, you can do this from the order book. So next one is check status. After you have placed the order, you can check the status of the same. The status would state open if the order is completely or partially open. It would state completed if the order has been completed. It would state rejected if your order book has been rejected. You can also see the details of rejection in the order book. Now if you notice, there is one order which is open for ITC at 261 rupees. If you however have any pending orders, you can find it in the option to modify or cancel the order. So guys, by clicking modify, and the order form will invoke, and you can make desired changes to the order. Once the order has been processed and the trade has been executed, the trade details will be available in the trade book. You can find the trade book just below the order book. Here is a snapshot of the trade book. By clicking on modify, the order form will be invoked and you can make the desired changes to the order. Once the order has been processed and the trade has been executed, the trade details will be available in the trade book. You can find the trade book just below the order book. Here is a snapshot of your trade book. The trade book confirms that the user executed an order by one share ITC at rupees 262.2. Also notice a unique exchange order number is generated for the trade. So with this cover, with this, the first task is completed. Now we can officially own, or now you officially own one share of ITC. This share will reside in your DMAT account till you decide to square it off. So the next task is to track the price of Infosys. The step would be to add Infosys to the market watch. We can do this by searching the Infosys's share in the search box. So when you search for INFI, that is INFI, the stock code of the particular stock that we are searching, which is Infosys, you can add by clicking on the green arrow button. The trading symbol of the Infosys is INFI. Once we select INFI, we press and add it to the market watch. So guys, this is how the terminal looks like. This is how you add a stock. We can now track some live information about Infosys. The last traded price is 1014 rupees and 75 paisa. The stock is minus 0.11% from the previous day's close of 1015 rupees 85 paisa. Infosys opened up today, I mean the day when this document was made, at rupees 1014 plus 80 paisa, which is 1014 rupees 80 paisa, made low of 998 rupees and 40 paisa and a higher of 1028 rupees and 95 paisa. The volumes were 3.6 million shares. Please note, while opening while the open price will be at 1014 rupees and 80 paisa, the high and the low prices will change when the price of Infosys changes. For example, if Infosys moves to rupees 1014.2 to 1050, then the prices will reflect as 1050 as the new high. Notice the live trading price of Infosys, which is highlighted in green, and ITC is in red. If the current live trading price is more than the previous live trading price, the sell is highlighted in green, else it is in red. So let's look at the snapshot below to understand. ITC is in red, which means it is going down, and INFI is going up, which is in green. So the price of Infosys dropped from 1014 rupees 20 paisa to 1020 rupees 80 paisa, hence the color changed to red from blue. So besides the basic information about live trading price, open, high, low and close and volume, we can also dig a bit deeper about understanding the real time market participation. To see this, we need to invoke what is called as market depth window, also referred to as snapcode window. You can also see there is a lot of information in the snap window. I specifically want to draw attention to the numbers in blue and red called bid and ask prices. You can use Kite by Zerodha more effectively by going through the user manual. The first one is the bid and ask price. If you want to buy a share, you obviously need to buy it from a seller. The seller will sell the share at the price that he thinks it is fair. The price that the seller asks you is called the ask price. The ask price is highlighted in red. Let us analyze this in a bit more detail. So by default, the snap quote window displays the top five bid ask prices, and in the table above we have the top five ask prices. The first ask price is rupees 3294.80. At this particular moment, this is the best time to buy. This is the best price to buy Infosys, and there are only two shares available at this price being offered by two different sellers. Both of them are selling 1 rupee each. The next best price is 3294.85. At this price, there are four shares available offered at two different sellers. The third best price is 3295, at which 8 shares are available. and this price is offered by two sellers, so on and so forth. As you notice, the higher the risk, higher the ask price, the lower the priority is. For example, at the fifth position, there is an ask price of 3,296.25 for 5 shares. This is because the stock exchange gives priority to sellers willing to sell their shares at the least possible price. Notice if you want to buy 10 shares at 3,294.8 and you can only buy 2 shares because there are only 2 sellers at 3,294. However, if you want to, or if you are not particular about the price, ask a limit, also known as the limit price. You can place an order. When you place an order in the market at this stage, this is what happens. 2 shares are bought at 3,294.8, 4 shares are bought at 3,294.85, 4 shares are bought at 3,294.00. The shares, 10 shares will be bought at 3 different prices. Also in the process, the live trading price of Infosys will jump from 3,295 to 3,294.8. So if you want to sell a share, you obviously need to sell it to a buyer willing to buy it from you. The buyer will be able to buy the share at the price that he thinks it is fair. The price that the buyer demands is called the bid price. The bid price highlighted in blue letters analyze this part in bold, this part in detail. Bit more detail again. By the default, the snap quote window displays the top 5 bid prices. Notice the best price at which you can sell the share is ₹3,294.75, and at this price you can actually sell 10 shares as there are only 5 buyers willing to buy from you. So if you were to sell 20 shares of Infosys market price, the following would be the execution pattern. 10 shares are sold at 3294, 6 shares are sold at 3294.20, 1 share is sold at 3294.15, 3 shares are sold at 3293.85. So in this essence, the bid and ask price gives you the information about the top 5 prices which the buyer and seller are stacked up. It is extremely important for you to understand how the buyer and sellers are placing their trade, especially if you are an intraday trader. So conclusion is, the trading terminal is your gateway to the market. Trading terminal has many features that are useful to traders. We will explore these features as we progress through the various learning modules. For now, we should be in a position to understand how the market is set up and the market watch is set up. Transaction of both buy and sell and stocks are also understood. The view of the order book, the trade of the trade that you are doing, the trade book, very essential to know and understand the market depth window. So guys, key takeaway from this chapter: a trading terminal is your gateway to markets. You must know the operations of a trading terminal if you aspire to become an active trader. Second point is, you can load the stock that you are interested onto market watch to track all the relevant information. Third one is, some of the basic information on the market watch is live trading price, percentage change, OHLC and volumes. To buy a stock, you need to invoke a buy order from by pressing the B key. Likewise, to sell a stock, you need to invoke a sell order by pressing the S key. So it is basically, buying is B button, yes, sell is yes button, simple as that. So you choose to limit order type when you are keen on transacting at a particular price, else you can opt for a market order. You can choose cash and carry as product type if you want to buy and hold the stock across multiple days if you want to trade.